Hi, guys, welcome back to my channel. Please share and subscribe my channel to get more interesting topic.
Hey guys, how are you? Thanks to all of guys, because of that my channel has been monetized and it is only effort from you people. That's why, thanks again. So today's discussion about the electrode consumable and their classification. So what are the electrode consumable are there for different process and how you will classify it for particular electrode. So we'll discuss that one. So first one is this is you need to know the basic concept element of welding steel. Elements of welding steel, main elements which are added or reduced to certain level to produce specific properties. So these are the elements are required to make the after welding that property you are achieve at the same property in the base metal. So this is the element. So this is the element what they are giving the strength we need to know. Carbon. What is carbon? What is they are giving? They're giving that the key element in the steel has a major influence on the strength, toughness, ductility and hardness. So carbon is the major element. If you go in the steel also in the pyramid metal, also major element is the carbon. So in the oil, in the filler or in the electrode, also in the carbon is the main material, main element. So has a major influence in the strength, ductility, toughness, ductility and hardness. Manganese, what is their effect? Primary desulfurized and secondary deoxidizer, often added in order to enable the carbon content to be reduced, affect strength and the hardenability. So if it is sulfur is there, so then manganese is need to desulfurize that. Sulfur is there, sulfurized crack will become secondary deoxidizer. Then manganese, if it is there in the, it will not be oxidation, it will not be oxidized. So manganese, that what is it, desulfurizer and deoxidizer, often added in order to enable the carbon content to be reduced. Silicon, what are the use of silicon? Primarily deoxidizer, same deoxidation. When if oxide is there, definitely there is oxidant and corrosion will come. So silicon also same thing, primary deoxidizer, reduce toughness if too much exists. If there is a too much excess toughness is there, then silicon, if it is there, then toughness will be reduced. Aluminium, this is the very important, define the grainer, grain definer and tetroid deoxidizer. Aluminium, that's why we are calling some percentage is there in the aluminium, that is called killed steel and semi-killed steel. Killed means this is grain definer. Molybdenum improves creep resistance and reduce temper embattlement. So improves creep resistance and reduce temper embattlement. Chromium improve hardness and resistance to ore. Say chromium, if it is there, generally it is for stainless steel we are using. This manganese, aluminium, molybdenum and chromium, molybdenum and chromium we are using in if you can find out in stainless steel filler metal. So improve hardness and resistance, because stainless steel, it is very important stainless and it should not be corroded. So that's why we are using stainless steel, some of the area that it is the very stringent area. Nickel improves ductility, strength and toughness. And in austenitic stainless steel, it improves resistance to corrosion from acids. So this is the carbon, manganese, silicon, aluminium, molybdenum, chromium, nickel. This is what they are doing, their role. So this is discussed here. Most steel element which present in undesirable amount may be considered as impurity. Sulfur, phosphorus is in particular are usually kept to level 0.05%, because the sulfur may prompt hot shortness and the phosphorus may prompt the cold shortness. So phosphorus and sulfur should be labeled below 0.05%, and if it is there, then sulfur, then it will become the hot shortness and cold shortness. Then it is the defect will come and the pyramid metal when you are doing welding. So this is the element of the welding steel. So electrode selection, how you will select the electrode? So this is the basic idea, selection of the electrode. I have given one video, I have already uploaded, so you can check there. how we can choose the electrode. This is the only basic concept I am giving here, because the electrode, so many things are there we need to discuss in this topic. Most steel can be welded with the electrode having weld metal composition similar or to the parent metal. So whenever you are going to the electrode, you have to check the base metal composition and the weld metal composition is should be similar, then we can use that electrode. So low and medium carbon steel can be welded with 6013 class of electrode. So low and medium carbon steel, if you see the chemical composition, it is same as the E6013 class of electrode. So I will discuss what is this 6013, what are the classification in the next page. Although for the higher thickness preheating will have to be carried out, as the section thickness and carbon content increase in the hedge become more prone to hydrogen induced induced cutting. So if it is thickness is more and the carbon content is more, then the hedge becomes the more prone to cracking, because the hydrogen is there counter. So that's why we are using that time the low hydrogen electrode will have to be used to remove the hydrogen. Electrode conforming to AWS E701 it combines the embedded advantage of higher deposition rate and the low hydrogen in the weld metal. So you understand 6013, there is this specific 6013 we can use in specific area, not for all area. If the thickness is the more, then the hydrogen, you have to use the low hydrogen electrode. High tensile low alloy carbon content higher than the mild steel. Definitely high tensile low alloy steel, it all if have carbon content more than the mild steel with alloying addition is the chromium, nickel, nickel, molybdenum, and so this is chromium, nickel, molybdenum, it is the addition of the metal. In certain cases vanadium, vanadium also in certain cases. So high tensile low alloy steel, you can see the chemical composition, it's added with it's more than it's the addition of the chromium, nickel, and molybdenum and vanadium. Electrodes with matching composition accompanied by preheat up to 300 degrees centigrade. So in this case, high tensile low alloy steel, you have to preheat up to 300 degrees to remove the hydrogen. Hydrogen induced, so it prevents the hydrogen induced crack. In certain cases, post heat treatment are required to avoid cracking. So definitely post heat treatment, BWHT, preheat, and the post heat. Both are all are involved in the cracking. Use of ostentatious stainless steel electrode combined with preheat is necessary to prevent kind high alloy material. So alloying with chromium and molybdenum and sometimes vanadium is done with case of pre resistant steel. So if it is keep resistant steel, we are using the alloying with chromium and molybdenum and sometimes vanadium. So design with pre-resistant strength, low hydrogen electrode with similar chemical composition to weld metal. So this is the electrode selection, how you electrode selection, but electrode you have to select, but this is the basic concept you have to go. If it is the SS material, you have to check the base metal and the which material we are using. You have to choose SME section to part C and which one is the SS material. That SS material chemical composition and you are using that base metal, it should be shared. Same or it should be higher. Addition of minimum 12% chromium to steel makes it stainless. So if it is 12% chromium in the steel, then it means it is stainless steel. This property is due to the formation of the thin oxide layer, thin oxide plane. There is a thin oxide plane Cr2O3 on the surface of the steel. Nickel addition of the amount of 8% more makes the stainless steel austenitic. So if it is addition nickel is more 8%, then it comes to the austenitic stainless steel. So addition of minimum 12% is if you find the chemical composition is 12%, it's called the stainless steel. And if the nickel addition is amount it is 8%, then it's the austenitic stainless steel plus including the chromium 12%. So this is how you electrode selection. This is a basic concept. And the marking of packages, you see how you when you are electrode purchasing, so you need to know what are the marking should be there in your boxes. So AWS specification and classification number, so it should be AWS specification and the classification number, and year of issue, there is which year it is issued. This should be supplier name and trade designation, which supplier you are purchased from, which supplier, and the trade designation should be there. In the case of the composite electrode, the trade designation of the class with the which is weld metal composition meets the requirement table 2. So if it is a composite electrode, then class and the electrode both from where it is coming, the designation of the composite electrode, the trade then we have to mention the size and net weight. What are the size are there for the filler metal or electrode? We have to mention and the weight. What are the weight? Lot control and the heat number. There should be very important. The lot control and heat number should be there. So this is the basic thing A, B, C, D, E. These five things should be there when you are purchasing the electrode from the market. So what are the main things for SMAWAT welding? There is a covering is there. There is different types of covering, different requirements. So if you go to the cellulosic, rutile, rutile heavy coated and basic. There is a four types of covering is there. So what is cellulosic? Cellulosic means contains a large quantity of combustible organic substance so that the decomposition of the latter and the produce the volumic acid. So gas will be produced more. Because cellulosic is a higher hydrogen, the high volumetric gas will become more. Then slag is easily detachable. What are the advantages there? Slag is you can easily remove the slag, amount from is also less, and if the slag also will be from will be less. Highly penetrating arc and fairly high fusion rate. So fusion rate is very high and penetration is highly. Spatter losses are fairly high and bead is coarse. So spatter also losses is fairly high. Spatter losses are fairly high. Generally used for DC and sometimes with AC. So you are using this electrode always used, generally used 80 minutes, normally used for DC and sometimes we can use for AC. Suitable for all position. This cellulosic electrode we can use for the all position. So what are the electrode are there? E60, this is the one example, E6010, E6011. So this type of electrode, this is the electrode we can call the cellulosic electrode. So what are the classification? You see E6011, what are the classification? E means stands for electrode. 60 stands for 60,000 psi minimum tensile strength, 1 stands for all position, and 0 stands for current and coating strength. So 0, how from where you can find that what current and what coating will be there for 0? So you need to go for current and coating strength details. Please refer ASME section to part C 2015 page number 36 table 1. Please see the next page. So next page you can see. So another thing, 1 stands for all position. If it is 2, then it will be flat and horizontal. 3 means flat. So we need to know 1, 2, 1, 3. What are the meaning of welding position 1, 2 and 3? 1 means all position, 2 means flat and horizontal, 3 means flat only. You see table 1, this is 0. You see E6010, so means 0 means high cellulosic sodium. This is the type of covering. If it is 1, then it is high cellulosic potassium. If it is 2, then high titanium celladium. So you can use the welding position, which position you can use. We can work for this particular electrode, flat, vertical, overhead and horizontal. That's why we mention all, means this is 4 position. Type of current, which current we are using for this one, E6010, DCEP. We have to use for DCEP. So this is a main electrode classification from where you have to find ASME section to part C. For this is for only for SMAW. Easily and the, okay, this is pause. Now you have to go the rutile coated. So we have finished already cellulosic, now is rutile coated. Rutile coated, how it is easier to handle, it is handled very easy. More pleasing operating characteristics, smooth are easy deslagging, flatter weld bits. Means weld bits, if the flat is the weld bit, not is more high. Deslagging is very easy. Arc is very smooth. Smooth means arc initiation and the arc stable is very good. Relatively wide range of the weld current. If the weld wide range, this there is a wide range of the welding current, means if it is not only 70 to 100, it's maybe 80 to 120 130, we can use for a particular rutile coated electrode. Where you can find from how much current we have to use, you can see the manufacturer recommendation in the packet. It's mentioned there in this particular electrode how much current we can use, and after that we have to go the WPH, and WPH will confirm that the particular how much current we have to use for the job. Less care required with regard to moisture and hence less regard as redying schedule. So less care required there. Moisture, if it is moisture is there, the less care. It is not needed to care for the if it is moisture is done. Moisture is captured. Less pickup of carbon by weld metal. So it is now when you are welding, it will not be carbon, it will not be become any carbon by weld metal. So if it is carbon for weld metal, then it will be problem. It is a contamination, and the contamination it comes to the defect. So example, you see E6012-6013, it is same as there, only the change is 2. 2 stand for current coating strength. Same as there, you have to go the 6012. You see here flat vertical and high titanium sodium. The 6012, you understand this one, E means what? 60 means 60,000 psi, 1 stand for all position and 2 stand for defect. And rutile heavy coated. So similar in rutile, but in the coating ratio is more. So there is a coating ratio. So coating ratio for rutile is 1, and the coating ratio is more than the rutile, that is above 1.5. Usually prefer for flat, horizontal and vertical position. Rutile heavy coated electrode, we can use the flat, horizontal, vertical position. Example, E7024. So 70 means 70,000 psi, E means electrode. 2 stands for flat and horizontal, and 4 stands for current and coating strength. Same, you have to go 4. So what is 4? 4 is mentioned E7024. 4 is the iron pyro titanium. So this is the 4. This is 4. So you have to check AFME section 2, part C 2015, page number 36. Now basic coated. This is very important electrode we have to use for boiler, pressure vessel, a heavy steel structure, also in the pipeline, and you can use it. Lower sulfur level in the well meter. It is a very important lower sulfur level. Sulfur level is not, sulfur impurity is if there. If sulfur is there, the sulfur impurities will be there in the weld metal. This is called with the sulfur will become a defect. So lower sulfur level, it's good for the weld metal. Better control over weld chemistry on account of greater degree of gaseous shielding. So better control of weld chemistry is the better control for E7001. Very much lower pickup of nitrogen by weld metal. So nitrogen will not pick up, it will be pick up lower. Very much smaller influence arc length. So arc length, it's smaller influence. Arc length, it is means this E7001 arc stable is very good. Arc stable is very good. Hence, better control over the ferrite content of the weld metal. So if there is a ferrite control, if the carbon content, the ferrite content is very, control is this for this particular weld electrode. Penetration is very good. A future with the beneficially particularly in the fillet wells. Superior mechanical property, especially impaction temperature below. Its mechanical property is very good, is below the temperature. If you are using any temperature, if you are working at temperature minus 100 degree centigrade, you can use steel in C701 it, and you have, they will give, and this electrode will give the good mechanical property with impact strength. Typically, application include the welding of carbon steel sensitive to hydrogen. So we are using particularly for this one hydrogen, typically using for hydrogen embrittlement. Because those are material we can use. If it is the hydrogen, then pressure vessel and the heat exchanger and all the heavy structure. If we are using, then if it is the hydrogen induced is there, hydrogen will be induced there, and hydrogen induced cracking will become, then it will be a big problem. That's why we need to use that time hydrogen induced, hydrogen embrittlement. It will not be happen. That's why we are using E7018 electrode. So this is also same E7018. How will classify? 70 means 70,000 psi for this one. E stand for N1, stand for oxidation. 8 stand for current coating strength. So you have to go 8. What is 8 mentioned? 8 is the low hydrogen potassium iron pyro. You see low hydrogen. Okay. Then next phase is the pre-question of redrying. Redrying. How will redry the redrying the pre-question, how we need to pre-question for redrying. The electrode should not be redried for a very extended time beyond the value indicated in table 1 unless the manufacturer have mentioned special. So the redrying is the one time is acceptable, that is a 250 to 300 degree centigrade is there. It's 2 hours have to drying, we have to dry the electrode. But this is not the actual, you have to go the manufacturer recommendation. The minimum retained temperature must be at a higher temperature could be used specifically recommended by the manufacturer. Repeated re-drying should be avoided as it is reduced coating strength. If it is repeated re-drying, then it will be coating strength will be reduced. Re-drying should not be carried out more than 3 times. It depends on the manufacturer recommendation sometimes. If very wet electrode has to be re-dyed, it must first keep 100 degrees centigrade for about 15 minutes. If it is wet electrode, very wet electrode, you should not go first 250 degrees centigrade. You have to keep the 100 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes before being put in the re-dyeing oven. This will be avoid cracking on the flux cover due to the sudden evaporation of the moisture from the coating. The size of the electrode also influence the temperature, and the lower size electrode will get re-dyed at lower temperature and lesser time. Manufacturer advice may be sought from the revised temperature. For hydrogen control electrode, always re-dyeing is permissible than the one recommended at the strength level. Higher strength level electrode require higher temperature for re-dyeing. So higher strength level electrode require higher temperature for re-dyeing, definitely. However, re-dyeing is 350 degrees centigrade for 2 hours or beyond 400 degrees centigrade more than 1 hour may oxidize. So, the hydrogen control electrode, we have to re-dry first baking re-dyeing 350 degrees centigrade for more than 2 hours. Then we have to keep that electrode in the another portable oven in 100 degrees centigrade, and you can use that electrode at work time. So this is the cycle. The cycle of the re-dyeing electrode. This is a very important thing. General purpose of the mild steel coat. There is a 3 types of rutile, cellulosic, basic coating. So rutile, if you go, the re-dyeing condition is the 135 plus 10. So if the wet electrode is there, you can re-dye 135 degrees. Time is 60 minutes, 1 hour. Holding condition is 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. So 40 to 45 degrees centigrade, you have to keep 1 hour, time is 1 hour, 135 degree condition, 135 degree temperature. So this is cellulosic, and if you see basic coated, it is 250 degree centigrade, 260, time is 2 hours, and you have to holding condition 130 degree centigrade, you have to hold that temperature. Stainless steel electrode 260, 120 and the same. Stainless steel electrode hardness, if it is basic stainless steel electrode, and the hardness and nickel based non-ferrous, so everything in the re-dyeing condition is mentioned in there. The cycle of the re-dyeing electrodes. So this is whatever we discuss now, it is for SMAW electrode. Now this is for specification for the carbon steel electrode and fluxes for submerged arc welding. So submerged arc welding means SAW welding. This specification states the requirement for the classification of the carbon steel electrode, both solid and composite, and flux or flow. So you can see here, this is the very common example for submerged welding, arc welding flux with the electrode solid oil. So F7A6EM12K classified. How will classify this electrode? F means indicate flux, 7 means indicate the weld metal minimum tensile strength KPSI into 10 when using the flux with the electrode identifier. 7 indicates means 70,000 KPSI. A means designated the condition of heat treatment into the well on which test were conducted. So heat treatment condition, A means as welded, and P means if it is mentioned P, then it is PWHT. A means as welded. 6 means indicates the lowest temperature at which the charge value of 227 joule was achieved. So 6 means indicates the lowest temperature if into 10 at which the charge value 27 joule was achieved. So this is the end of flux designation. So we'll go the solid wire. E means indicate solid wire electrode. EC would indicate the composite electrodes. If it is mentioned EC, then it will be the composite electrode. M means this may be either L, M or H, indicating low, medium or high manganese content. So if it is L means low manganese, if it is M means medium manganese, and H means high manganese. 12 means this is the 1 or 2 digit and indicates the nominal carbon composition of the electrode. carbon content. If it is 12 means 0.12% carbon, 8 means if it is 8 then it is 0.08% carbon, and K indicates the electrode the made from the semi-crystal. So this is the basic concept EF7, A6, EM12K. What are the meaning of this electrode? So next page is the function of flux. What are the flux function? We need to know. Flux, what are their work? The function of the flux can be summarized as follows. They provide the gas seal protecting the earth and will pull from the atmospheric oxygen. So we need the flux for because of the gas shielding protecting the earth. We need the where is the welding is going on, and that time shield is important to stable the earth and the good mechanical property and remove the oxygen from there. So oxygen and nitrogen, which can cause elution and reduction of the weld ductility. This is the main function of the flux. To provide a slag which gives additional shielding of weld pool and assist the manipulation during welding. The slag also creates a thermal blanket slowly cooling and defining. So this is very important, this slag also creates a thermal blanket. Means this is the cooling down is very slowly and it will be then refined will be the grain structure. If it is grain structure will be good, then mechanical property you can achieve. So to improve the physical property of the earth, the coating additive may improve earth initiation, earth stability. Flux we can use two types. One is fused and agglomerated. What is fused? The granulated flux, and the powder is the agglomerated flux. So granulated is the granulate type and powder is the powder form. So fused flux, what is this fused flux? The ingredients are mixed and melted at a high temperature. So the ingredient of the fused flux are mixed and melted at a high temperature. They are melted. The mixture is then poured. The mixture after mixed, you have to pour onto the large chill blocks directly to the stream of water to produce the granules which have the third glassy appearance. The material is then crushed and sieved to size. After that, when the large chill blocks and direct to the stream of the water produce granules from, then you have to crush the material and you have to maintain a size and package. This is fused flux. What are the advantages? Good chemical mix achieved. They do not attract moisture, the easy removal of impurities and fine particles. So this is good chemical mix achieved. The chemical is good. They do not attract moisture. Moisture will not be attracted, and the easy removal impurities and the fine particles. Impurities and fine particles, it can be easy removal. Agglomerated flux, how it is? All the flux material are dry mix. It should be dry mix. It is not in the melted in the water form. In the water, you see here, it's mentioned here, the ingredient mix and melted with the high temperature. And the mixture is then poured into large chill box or direct to the stream of the water production. So, same here, it is different. All the flux material are dry mix. It should be mixed, a dry mix, and then bonded with potassium and sodium silicate. It should be bonded with potassium or sodium silicate and baked at a temperature below the melting point. It should be baked at a temperature below the melting point, not more than melting point. The powder received and size and pack. Advantage, what are the advantages there? Easy addition of the deoxidant and the pyrolysis. Means deoxidant, you can add deoxidant means it prevents the oxygen. So that material you can easily add easy addition of deoxidant and the ferroalloys. Disadvantage, what are the disadvantages of there and agglomerated flux? Absorb moisture, difficult retrying and recycling, difficult removal of impurities. The three things is very important for disadvantage for agglomerated. Absorb moisture, moisture will be absorbed in the when you are doing and flux, the absorb will be absorb may be collect from the weld metal or the base metal. Difficult retrying and recycling. Retrying and recycling is the very difficult. Difficult removal imperatives. So the straw welding it is finished. Now is the mag or mid pillar wire. You see mag is the ER70H2. We are using that electrode for mag or mid. What is the mag? Metal active gas, and M means metal inert gas. So ER70H2, what are the meaning? Electrode and rod for the ER7 is to classification and primary, it's a single pass welding. So whatever the single pass welding we are using, we can use the ER70H2 electrode. So off kill or semi kill or demi skill, rim skill, but may be used from multi-pass application. Sometimes we can use in the multi-pass application because of the added dioxidant. This pillar metal can be used the welding skill that have a rusty dirty surface. Same we can use ER70H2 and ER70S6. So ER70H2, what are the meaning, and 7S6 we all will discuss in the next page. Electrode and rods of the ER70S6 classification are intended for the both single and multi-pass welding. So this electrode we can use for the both single and multi-pass welding. They are especially suited for the sheet metal application. So 70S2, 70S6, then we can use for the sheet metal application, and there is a specific thickness of the metal. After that we cannot use for the 70S6. It's maybe 3mm to 6mm. They have specifically suited for sheet metal application when smooth weld bits are desired, and structural and the plate seal have moderate amount of the rust of mixing. This electrode withstand high currents with CO2 shielding. So this electrode withstand high current. It can withstand that electrode even when the holding medium steel. Typically base metal specification are often in the same as those in the ER70H2 classification. So 70H2 and 70H2, you can understand this is what we can use for the mag and MIG filler wire. Specification, or how means it is a classification, MIG or TIG wires. The E means what are the same, the ER indicates the filler metal may be used either an electrode or a rod. So Y means rod, electrode rod, ER means electrode rod. The number 70 indicates 70,000 PSI. That minimum tensile strength. The letter S means the solid electrode. S means ER70S6 means there is no flux is using. So this is the solid electrode S. Metal inert casualty. The letter C designates the composite electrode. The digital following the hyphen 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 indicate the chemical composition of the filler metal. So this S means the solid electrode. So and when you are using, you see C designated the composite electrode. After that ER70S6, that C means composite electrode, and in this area, in this C, if it is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then it is the chemical composition of the electrode. The letter M or C will follow indicate the type of the shielding gas. So the letter M or C, if it is mentioned, will follow the indicate the type of shielding gas, which type of shielding gas we are using, if it is argon, if it is carbon dioxide, like this. So this is the specification of the MIG MAG TIG wires. E, 70, S and 6 is the chemical composition. S means it is a solid electrode, and M or C, if it is mentioned, then indicating the type of shielding gas. This is a very useful information for the welding engineer. We need to know it is totally directly involved with the electrode rod or filler rod. Heat input means E into I into 60 kilojoules per mm, S into 100. This heat input is directly related with hardness and all the mechanical properties. So we need to know the heat input. It should be there in the correct form. How we can calculate. E is the arc voltage in volts, I is the welding current. Arc voltage you can take from the WPH, current you can take from the WPH, and S is the rate for the travel in minimum. So travel rate you can also find from the WPH. So this gives the theoretical heat input, not taking into account losses in the radiation. It is so this is the carbon equivalent. This is a heat input formula. You can find out the heat input. Carbon equivalent, you see. Carbon equivalent C plus Mn by C is chromium black material. So you need to know the carbon equivalent, carbon percentage. If it is, you see, CE carbon equivalent is 0.40 less than the plate thickness, less than 37 mm, and diffusible hydrogen for CE. If it is CE less than 0.40, then plate thickness it should be 37 mm, less than 37 mm. Content less than 10 mm preheat is generally not equal. So this is some important information are there, the useful information for the welding engineer. Percentage ferrite by calculation, conversion of H2, this one glycerin formula for pitting, index calculation, temperature conversion. How will cost the calculation welding cost? How will welding cost you have to calculate? Welding cost is a very variety of decision. You see, welding speed is, how will that calculate the welding speed? A is equal to D by A into D. What is D? S means welding speed. What is D? D means deposition rate, kg per hour, and A into D. A means cross-sectional area of the joint, and D means density of the weld metal. Then you can find out the welding speed. So all these abbreviation are mentioned here. You can find out so many formula here. Welding speed, meters of the weld produced, labor cost per meter of weld, electrode and wear cost per meter of weld. This is the very important for the, if you are doing in the production, in the industry, and if it is project in the construction, this is very important. Welding, electrode, wear cost per meter of the weld. So in that case, we have to find out the electrode, which electrode is suitable for this particular project. Gas cost per minute, per meter per weld. So this is five cost, five calculation is very important, you need to know. And this is the last two, three pages are there. It is mentioned the area and weight of the weld metal deposit. So weld metal for particular joint, if it is thickness 1/8, so what are the weld deposit theoretical? 0.00027 pound per feet. So what are the reinforcement weight? If it is 0.030. So from here, every joint design, you can find out the which thickness and what are the weld metal deposit weight per foot. It's mentioned here. This is very important. You can find out the all types of joint material weight here. You can see here, you joined one side, you want the two sides, you join, see here, group join, everything you can find out here. So that's all, the electrode consumable classification, the details and their specification. I think everybody understand this one. Please, I need to know if there is any concern from your side. Thanks again. Thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to share and subscribe my video to your social networks or any of the areas to share my channel. And thanks again, because of my channel has been monetized because of your people have given the good effort for this channel. Thanks again.